click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in our previous lecture we have talked about that is catalyst as well as the role of catalyst. As well as we have also discussed about the enzymes also, which are known as to be the biological catalyst. And now we are going to a topic that is basically known as colloidal state. So what is colloidal state and what are the terms that are involved in that concept? So let us learn about it. So now let us understand that what does the colloidal state means. So let us understand its definition and then we are going to move with its other terms that have been involved in that. So now let us understand it first. That is, the colloidal state of a substance refers to a particular particle size of the substance that is ranging between 1 nanometer to 10 raised to 3 nanometer, which it acquires on the treatment with a solvent. For example, there are three kinds of solution, if I would say. That is, one is true solution, one is colloidal solution, and one is suspension. So these are the three things that we are going to talk about in this whole chapter. But meanwhile, we are going to talk about the colloidal state first in this case. Then only we could move on towards the next topic, that is suspension. But there are also certain topics that are being involved in this. So we are also going to talk it in this lecture only. But talking about the colloidal state, yes, these are the particles which having a range of that is 1 nanometer to 10 raised to 3 nanometer. And again, this are been they are been dissociated or they are get dispersed in a particular solvent. So basically these are a kind of solution, but the thing is it is not a true solution. As we know that true solution has the particle size which is less than 1 nanometer. And that's the reason that we cannot observe the particle size with our naked eye. But talking about this colloidal state has a particular size that is from 1 nanometer to 10 raised to 3 nanometers. So that could be observed in terms of a microscope also. So these are the things that we are going to talk about. But yes, there are also few terms that have been involved in that. And what are those? Let us understand that one. So colloidal state is basically something which is the one which has a particle size of this range, as well as it has been that is dissolved or it has been present in a particular solvent and through. So that will make basically a colloidal dispersion. So what is colloidal dispersion? Let us talk about that. So we are now talking about that is colloidal dispersion. So what is colloidal dispersion? Let us understand its definition first and then we are going to move on further. So talking about this thing, that is the colloidal dispersion, also known as colloids, is a heterogeneous two-phase system with the dispersion medium as one phase and the dispersed substance as the other phase. And there is definite surface of separation between each colloidal particle and dispersion medium. So let me explain this with the help of an example that is also we are going to talk about in this lecture only. So colloidal dispersion, as we have got to know about the colloidal state, means they are particles that consist of basically from 1 nanometer to 10 raised to 3 nanometer. So talking about colloidal dispersion is a heterogeneous phase. And what is heterogeneous phase? That is, it is involving that is two phases, that is either it could be solid or either it would be gas or either it could be solid liquid. So there are various possibilities also that we are going to talk about. So one of the phase will be called as a dispersion phase, while the other one will be called as a dispersion medium. And all the size of the particle that would be ranging from that is 1 nanometer to 10 raised to 3 nanometer. And yes, since they are the two phases that have been involved in that case, so that is the reason that it is known as heterogeneous. And we know it is something different from that of the true solution because, for example, if we consider that suppose 1 gram of sugar has been dissolved in 1 glass of water and we dissolve it. So the solution that has been formed or a substance that has been overall it has been formed, it is a liquid state substance and that is basically the sugar solution. So that is of single phase, that is homogeneous phase. But this is a heterogeneous phase that we could get and it is a mixture of two phases. And but still it is a heterogeneous system where we could find. So we can see the dispersion phase and the dispersion medium, they are being separated with each other because of their size in the colloidal particles also, as well as there are also certain things that we are going to talk about in this one. So since we have talked about dispersion medium as well as the dispersed phase, so what are those two? Let's talk about this one also. Or we could say that it is a part of a colloid. So what does the dispersed phase means? So let us understand it. The colloidal particle of the size ranging between 1 nanometer to 10 raised to 3 nanometer that are present in the dispersion medium represents the dispersed phase, which is discontinuous phase. So basically, we could say in that manner also that is we know about solution. That is, solution is made up of that is solute and solvent. So dispersed phase are just like the solute that have been dissolved in a particular medium or that have been dissolved in a particular solvent. So in this case, basically the dispersed phase are those particles which are being present in the dispersion medium. And either it could be less quantity or more quantity. But the thing is, yes, they are discontinuous phase. Yes, they are discontinuous phase. The reason behind that is because this kind of phase, that is, it could be solid, liquid, or any kind of phase that we are going to talk about. So they get dispersed in that medium, and the medium is of more quantity. So that's the reason that they are discontinuous. While the other talking about the other one, that is the dispersion medium, it is a continuous phase, and let us talk about that also. So talking about the example of this two. So suppose if I say that that is mist, or we could say like smoke, even they are the colloidal particles, and in which we could say that the solid phase or the liquid phase, they get dispersed in the gaseous medium, and that's the reason that the smoke or the mist has been formed. So in this case, basically the particle size are very much small, and the particle size are basically from 1 nanometer to 10 raised to 3 nanometer. But meanwhile, when I'm talking about that solid phase, so that solid phase is getting dispersed in the gaseous phase, and that's the reason that the gaseous phase is basically known as, it is a continuous medium, as well as that could be known as the dispersion medium, while the one which get dispersed is basically known as the dispersed phase. So that is what we are going to talk about in this one also. So let us understand the other possibility that we could find for the colloidal system, and what are those? Let us talk about that. So here we are going to talk about that how many colloidal systems are been possible. So there are basically 8 colloidal systems that are been possible. So let me talk about that. So if I differentiate that how many types of system or colloidal system that can be formed, so let me introduce in this way, where I could represent. So these are the 3 things that I am going to talk about. So let us understand that is the dispersion medium, the possible 8 that is colloidal system. So talking about the first one, that is, suppose if we have a dispersion medium which is of solid. So if solid is the dispersion medium that we have, and in that case we could say that even the liquid can be dispersed in that, or liquid phase can be dispersed in that medium. So that is the reason that I am representing here as, suppose if a liquid phase. So this is one of the possibility where we have a liquid phase as well as the dispersion medium is solid. So the name of this system is called gel. Yes, gel is the one which is having the dispersed phase as liquid, while the dispersion medium is a solid. Because as we know that gel is basically solid in nature, that we know, because it is a continuous phase, that we know that dispersion medium is a continuous phase. But meanwhile, there is the liquid that is getting dispersed in that medium, and hence we, and that kind of system is basically known as gel. So this is one of the example. For example, if I would say like, I hope you know that we use gel in our daily basis, like in hairs or like as a face wash. But also cheese, butter, these are also a kind of gel which are of the, that is, which are having the dispersed phase as a liquid and the dispersed medium as a solid. So this was one of the colloidal system. Now let me talk about the other one, that is, in which basically the solid is again, suppose, is the dispersion medium, and the solid is basically the dispersed phase. So in this case, basically this kind of system is basically known as soles. But since this sole is made up of solid that has been dispersed in the solid, so therefore this could be called as solid sole. And talking about the example, that is we could say like ruby glass. So that ruby glass is also to be called as an example where we could see that it could be called as solid sole. Or we could say like gold in glass, even that could be said as solid sole, because we know that gold is solid and the glass, which is also solid, so therefore it could be called as solid sole, and the name of the system is solid sole. So now let us move on with the next one, that is, what if we have, that is, the dispersion medium as solid and the dispersed phase as gas. So in this kind of example where solid is the dispersion medium and the gas is the dispersed phase, in which we could say that the gas has been distributed or the gas has been dispersed in the solid medium. So that kind of system is basically known as foam. So this is basically known as foam that we know about, but this foam is basically known as solid foam, because the dispersion medium is of the solid phase. So that is what we have. So these are the three possible coronal systems that we have mentioned about. But yes, there are also the further examples that we are going to talk about. And they are basically. Now we have talked about the dispersion, that is the dispersed medium that was of the solid phase. And now we are going to mention about the dispersion medium, which is of the liquid phase. So if the dispersion medium is of liquid phase and the dispersion phase is also the liquid phase, then that kind of system is basically known as emulsion. For example, milk is an emulsion. How? Because the liquid phase, or we could say that is the dispersion phase, that is of liquid phase, while that is of the dispersion medium is also of the liquid phase. So these are the two phases, but yes, they are still called to be, or this kind of colloidal particles are still called to be, that is heterogeneous system. The reason behind that is because of the particle size and because of their discontinuous nature, what the dispersion have, dispersed phase have, and that is basically it is known as the emulsion. And now let us talk about the next one, that is, if the dispersion medium is of the liquid phase, while that of the dispersed phase is of, suppose it is of solid phase, then that kind of system is basically known as SOL. So we have mentioned about the SOL earlier also, that is during the name of the system, where the dispersion phase or the dispersed phase was the solid and the dispersion medium was again solid. So that kind of soul that we have mentioned, so that was solid soul. And now this is what we have mentioned over here. Again, it is a soul, but here you could see that the dispersion medium is liquid. So therefore it could be called as liquid soul also. So this is an example that we have mentioned over here. I talk about the example. You could say that paints or milk of magnesia. So these are the two examples, one of the two examples that is we have mentioned about the soul. And now let us talk about, that is, what if, that is, liquid phase is the dispersion medium and basically the gas is basically acting as a dispersed phase. So this is what we could call it as, we could call it as foam. Even this kind of example we have did earlier, where the gas was the dispersed phase and it was being dispersing in a medium which was of solid phase, and that kind of system was known as solid foam. But this is known as foam, or we could call it as liquid foam. The reason behind that is because the gas is the phase which get distributes in, or which get dispersed in the medium which is of the liquid phase, and that's the reason foam is an example where the gas is being dispersed in the liquid medium. So these are the three examples, or these are the three systems which were been related to the dispersed phase, which was on the dispersed medium, which was of liquid phase. And now let us talk about the another two, and those are basically, that is, if the dispersed medium is of gas, and again, suppose if the dispersed phase is of liquid state, then this kind of system is known as aerosol. For example, like as I have mentioned earlier also, that is a foam or mist. So in this case, basically the liquid which is of which is known as the dispersed phase, that has been distributing, or that has been dispersing in a medium which is of gas phase. So that's the reason the name of the system is known as aerosol. And the example like mist or fog, these are the examples of the aerosol. And let us talk about the last one, that is, if the dispersion medium is of gaseous phase and the dispersed phase is of solid phase. So again, this kind of system is also known as aerosol. Because if you observe that as whenever a liquid is been, that is it has been dispersing in a solid phase, or it is known as sol. But here also the liquid, or the liquid has been dispersing in the gaseous phase, or in the gaseous medium, if you could say in that manner, then that is known to be aerosol. And again, here also the solid has been dispersing in the gaseous phase, as well as we have also got to know that whenever the solid has been dispersing in the liquid phase also, we have also seen that whenever the solid has been dispersing in the liquid phase, then also it has been called aerosol. But the one thing is common in this case is the both, that is the dispersed medium is of the gaseous phase. That is the reason the name is aerosol. The name of the system is aerosol. And talking about this example about aerosol, this one, in which basically the solid is been distributing in the gaseous phase. So this are the 8 possible colloidal system. And talking about the last one, that suppose if we consider that gas can be dispersed in the gas, so that would be considered as the colloid system. The reason behind that is whenever the gas it mixes with the gas, it forms a homogeneous system. And we know that colloidal particles or the colloidal state is a heterogeneous system. And that's the reason we are not including gas in gas. And so this were the 8 possible colloidal system that we have talked about, as well as we have also got to know about what are colloidal particles or what are colloidal state. So that's it, friend. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and will share this video with the friends. So till then, don't forget to subscribe to eKids channel. Thank you so much.